how to do it. These are way fun and they're super easy, guys. Like super, super easy. So if you want to save yourself some money and make your own really cute, just you have them, Mickey mini ears.
Okay, guys, so what you're gonna need is something to cut your fabric with, a headband. You will need some stuffing foam, some cardboard. I just use a Cheerios box. You can use cereal boxes. It doesn't have to be super thick. You need some fabric, and then emptytaze.com. And she has a printable pattern that you can use. I ended up using her baby ears because I don't like big things sticking out of my head, but you can do whatever you want. And I actually just did the fabric and the one for the foam or cardboard. So then you need to cut four pieces of your fabric. So I have this one, and then I'm gonna cut one more because I like to do mine so that they look like that, and then you'd flip it over and it would have the other mini with the other red. Okay, so let's cut our piece of fabric. So we will do this. And when you get your fabric, I found you only need about 7 inches of fabric to get this pattern on there. If you're doing the bigger one, I might do a full quarter of a yard. But this will make it, this will give you enough fabric to do a two pieces. So when we sew them, you put them right sides together. And you can mark if you want to. There's actually this sewing thing. You can put this on here and mark around it. But I just put it at the second hash on my sewing machine and then follow that all the way around. So let's go.
You want to make sure that your piece, like the piece that you want to come in, like this Mickey mini face, is further in, so you know that you're going to get it all on the air.
If you want to hand stitch them, you can just hand stitch them. I prefer sewing just because it's faster. And I have a sewing machine that I'm used to, so I just do that. So as you see, you just put it on this little inside. Let's see if I can get a picture of it. So the second hash right here, I just put it right at the inside of that where the second foot comes. And then sew all the way around that. So we'll just do this.
Now that we have those two pieces,
you need to pull them right side out. So you just do this, and it's okay if you don't get them completely unfolded nice and neat yet, but it doesn't take much, see? And there is an ear. And we'll get the other one. So we have these two ears, and we can either do it, put them on this, so it'd be more like this. You'd have one that could be reversible. Then we need to cut our pieces of cardboard. So what I did is I just took a cereal box and took the back of it, and I think I was able to get three sets of these out. With cutting these out after doing a few. So you want to cut on the inside of that line. So right there. So the orange or whatever marker you're using is on the outside. Because otherwise it ends up being just a little bit too big and you have to
Is you need to roll this.
So roll it with the bottom part. So this line matches up with your ear. So you roll it so you can fit it in here. Doesn't have to be super rolled or anything, you're just trying to make it so it fits in here. And then you stuff it in your ear and unfold it. Alright. You still may have to make some adjustments, just depending on how you have sewn your ear. But there's the ear.
So now you
take your stuffing, your batting, and
I like my ears not like super puffy, but I like them to look kind of rounded. You can do it however you want. If you're satisfied with just having the cardboard in there, then by all means, just keep the cardboard in there and don't worry about anything else. So I like to get the edges so that they're all like fluffed out. And I found that if you use smaller pieces of batting, and instead of like throwing this whole thing in there at once, it kind of stuffs better because you can put it in the spots that you need it more. So there's the one side, and I kind of leave this side hollow for the inner part. And then kind of push your finger down and start stuffing the other side. So that is your ear. Let's
now it's time to get ready to glue your ears. I have my two ears ready. They're stuffed. I've got my headband here. Let's get ready to glue. Like I said, I like to just fold this little piece of the cardboard over and then hot glue right there and then fold this other side over that. So it looks like a finished edge. So there's not strings hanging. Lay out. Okay, your so ears. You want to kind of get it. I just eyeball it because I'm not about measuring everything. But then you get your hot glue, get all those sticky pieces that might have been showing. Get that and put it on. Add it to your collection. This is how addicting they can be. Ear making. Hope this helps you make your own ears for your trip or just for fun.